judges that were courageous during the military. In part, they were courageous because they saw military regime as a regime that was not acceptable. I'm saying that now we think that we have democracy. Some of those judges think that this is democracy. And I'm saying it is not. Unless you have that mental shift, you cannot even begin to envision what you need to do to replace this and have something else. That's the point I'm making. So, we need revolution. But you talk about revolution now. Mm-hmm. I know what revolution now is. We have the arrowhead of that movement in detention. We need to get him.
So, because in the reality of today is that you have executive and National Assembly as one. Executive has swallowed National Assembly. So we have only, and they are almost swallowing the judiciary. So, but the judiciary is the only one we can now hold, that now that we have both National Assembly and the Executive as one, we only need the salvation of the judiciary. That's what we need to face, the judiciary that can save us from this your holy alliance between the executive and the legislature.
Our country has gone to the dogs, and the media must help. You have to help, and that is why the war is against the media, because for the 2023 race, the media must be silenced. You may have a third-term campaign very soon. Oh yes, very soon they are going to destroy all possible opponents, and they have started. So by the time they bring in the third-term agenda, the media will have been gone. But we're not going to allow it. And I've said it publicly, no dictator can defeat the Nigerian people. The point GT has made, please quote me as saying, no serious president, apart from a banana republic, will go to a private house in any country and sign a law. The bill has to be signed into law in the office of the president of a country. I'm sure even this cantankerous man in America, when he wants to sign a bill, Trump is a very serious business in the White House. GT, there is a case as president. Ladoja was impeached in a hotel in Ibadan, Deal Rover Hotel. And the Supreme Court made the point abundantly clear. Any proceedings of a House of Assembly that took place in a hotel are illegal, because the place for making laws is the chambers of the House of Assembly. So it's the office of the President of Nigeria where you sign law. They tried to deceive us by saying that bill was signed in the Nigerian house. No, it was signed in a private house, an undisclosed house in the United Kingdom, where a photograph was taken. But let me now tell you the danger of the statement granted to the chairman of APC that the president can rule from anywhere. You know, listen, that one has put Nigeria in trouble. You know, they said it. The 2010 budget was forged. We were told in Nigeria that they were taking the bill to Saudi Arabia. At that time, President Yar'Adua was in a state of coma. So they forged the budget. The other one they forged has put Nigeria in trouble, the BNI. Because the president was nowhere to be found. So that matter was not taken to the Federal Executive Council. So if they now say the president can rule from anywhere, you can be very sure many things are going to happen very soon.
Here has a history of attack on the media. This attack has now been extended to citizens who are critical of authority, particularly those that use social media as a tool to express their
opinion. Well, the media may still flag as a fourth estate. But the old faggots that fired the military through 38 years of misrule are still burning. The clampdown on dissent is becoming quite overwhelming. Beyond issues of imprisonment without trial of journalists, closure of media, they have emerged a very giddy legislative agenda to put all non-governmental organizations in manacles, manacles that are answerable only to the dicta of the party and government in power. The posting of the control of the social media, also as a matter of legislative maneuvers, has reached an advanced stage as a matter of legislation. The ongoing reduction of the military to police duties, requiring every inhabitant of the country to be covered by an apartheid-type search for positive identification, is a measure that is simply unthinkable in a democracy.